this meeting is, oh, no, we can't, we don't have a forum.
I have a forum.
We're waiting for one more member, just anxious to go on.
Somebody comes in with a planting plan and is suggesting arborvitae, tell them deer love it. Not a good choice anymore.
Do you remember Morton Field? All those, the arborvitae that were planted there were pulled out two or three times and they all died, or I guess 90% of them died.
Who went on Sunday?
Dave, myself, Harry.
Harry, was Harry, was he supposed to?
Al's not around.
Al and
Anika said.
Anika's not coming tonight, right?
No.
Yeah, and isn't Harry away?
Yeah, Harry should be here.
Yeah, those high bush blueberries got taken over by vines and thorns and they just, yeah, just died back. But back like in the mid-60s, you know, first week in July, second week in July, you go fill a spaghetti pot full of blueberries there.
Now that we have a quorum, tonight's meeting is called to order. And the meeting is being recorded for RCTV and it's live. Comcast Channel 22 or Verizon Channel 33. Check www.rctv.org for more information and for replay times. And first on the agenda is the Eagle Scout Project Town Forest under the townwide public trails maintenance. And this is TJ Kelly's Eagle Project. Mr. Kelly, would you like to tell us what you propose to do?
Okay, so I'm proposing an extension of the boardwalk on the Cranberry Dam Trail in the town forest by the back end of the council ring, right about where it meets the Pine Ridge Trail. And I put it on the map. You can see right on here. On here, right about there. And so the bridge from end to end is just over 30 feet. It would follow the same protocols as the bridges on the other side of it. The deck would be Trex synthetic decking with pressure treated underneath. If you, this location, when it gets rainy at all, really is not walkable or rideable. If you're on a bike or whatever you're on, it's too muddy. You would really have to go around. And also, boardwalk would help with any trail erosion and would keep people like on the trail and not in the bush harming plants or anything of that matter. I plan on using 2x10s in between these headers, which are also 2x8s driven in with 4x4s into the ground. And I'd have five stringers on joist hangers in between. So I'd use 6 4x4s and string 2x8s in between. And then lay the Trex decking on top with a small bumper on either side for bikes or possibly wheelchairs. I'm planning on putting like two screws on either end and one on in the middle along, so total of 8 screws.
8 screws on each board? Is that what you're saying?
Yes. So, 2, 2, 1, 2, 3, 7.
Yeah.
Did
you know
have
the
a
span
question?
Between the two the joists?
For the second two, it's 10 feet even, and for the first one, it's.
Oh no! Between.
Between these joists.
Spacing.
Is that like 1 foot? Yes, it'd be 1 foot.
is this a continuation of not the last Boy Scout project, but the one before that? Is this going towards Wood End School?
No, it's going the other direction. So it's going towards the council ring.
But it's close to the council ring?
Right.
Okay, but in its extension of that other particular project. And who do you remember whose project?
The last existing one is Ian Castrinos.
Okay.
Built just before the summer.
Just a construction question here. There's no kind of difficult to discern by this here what your header detail and what your post-bolting detail is. Now, those 4x4 posts, are those being buried in the ground?
Yes, we will bam them in.
You're just going to bam them in?
Yeah.
Okay.
Until point of refusal.
Yeah, we have an official bammer made out of drill casing.
One of the things is just from a construction standpoint, anything that's in a post, are these posts going to stand up because it's, so there's like a guardrail when people are going by?
We will cut them off.
Cut them off, okay. So these are just supportive?
Right.
Okay.
Make sure nothing's moving.
Is this also, Mr. Fitz, is this also the same construction detail that's been used in other areas in the past that's been approved by the Trails Committee?
Yes.
Okay.
TJ before Trails Committee.
Okay.
I've also gone before town forest.
Okay.
So I'll name it for the.
Do other members of the.
That ramp from the boardwalk to the trail, is that made out of the same material?
So actually, I know on this it says I would have a ramp, but I was planning on, I have a small update, but I would just make it flush into the ground.
Okay.
For this location, does this have to meet ADA slope?
I do not believe so, but
no.
No?
No.
This isn't acceptable?
It's out.
Accessible to someone in a wheelchair?
It's not, and it doesn't have to be, because it's out in the middle of the forest.
Okay.
But this particular boardwalk is probably going to meet ADA standards. So if someone wants to do a trail up to it, they could.
Mm-hmm.
It would be wheelchair usable, like if that's what the main reason for the bumpers on the side would be.
Mm-hmm.
But I mean, if you can get out there on a wheelchair.
I was thinking more of the pitch.
You know, because
the
pitch, like a wheelchair ramp, has to be a certain specification. So that was the only question I had, because I didn't see what the pitch of this was.
1 inch drop to every 12 inches out.
Yeah.
So I don't know if you have that. You think you have that?
I'm not exactly sure. I don't think it's.
It doesn't have to be.
We don't know what their other boardwalks are that
are
going for.
No, it doesn't have to. I was just wondering if it was closed. I mean, this picture makes it look a little. It looks like it's.
Yeah, so that's just a temporary ramp constructed by Ian Castrinos that I would be removing and building right off of where this one.
So that's what's there today?
Yes.
It's pretty.
Right.
Any other questions from the commission? Will, do you have any questions, comments?
Yeah, I think the 4x4 bammed into the ground is actually a little less intrusive than sometimes we use plastic pipes. So there's more ground contact with those, really. In this situation, these posts will work pretty well.
You haven't noticed any problem with them loosening up, or?
No, and over on the Cranberry Dam project, we did the 4x4s are actually acting as a retaining wall. So after we built the wall, we filled with limb pack in between it, and those aren't moving either. They went in pretty far. They probably went in 7 or 8 feet.
Had you been using the 4x4s and then switched to those pipes? You know, the culvert type black?
I think we used the black culvert first.
So the Kirchheim Woods, that's the design that you guys used when we had that grant.
Yeah.
And you've gone from that. So I've seen metal pipes and I've seen the culvert, the black culvert. And now it looks like we're doing 4x4 posts.
Yeah, It depends on the situation. But I know, you know, some Boy Scouts have used the pipes. It's kind of, you kind of know that the plastic is not going to rot over time. We always use the ground contact 4x4
mm-hmm.
material. In fact, on the cranberry dam, I'm using marine grade, the best grade. The only other comment we made to TJ and the Trails Committee was on the last section that goes down flush with the ground to make that, make sure that's ground contact,
right.
2x8 or 10 construction material. Because a normal pressure treated will rot if it's in contact with the material.
And when you contact the ground, that's going to have to take, you're going to have to scope that out beforehand because
right.
you don't want to cut any major roots that are in the ground. You have to figure out where that's going to land.
Yeah, the way we talked to it, like it ends just before there's a root,
right.
which is also higher up. So should work out pretty well.
Sounds good. We've seen this style of project before, and as seen after the scouts have finished them, they come out nice. It's a nice trail system.
When are you going to start doing it?
Planning for early November, but early to mid November, but that's penciled in. It's not
yep. Good.
We need to make any sort of motion with the ongoing.
Yeah, I would approve it underneath the 2700568.
So I make a motion to approve project under the townwide public trails maintenance.
Do I hear a second?
Second.
All those in favor? Okay. Thank you, Mr. Kelly.
Thank you.
Good job.
Good luck.
Will. Thanks, Will.
Does he have the fundraise to do this?
Yeah, that's part of it.
Really?
Was it Harry that seconded?
Scouts project.
Harry, you seconded?
Yes.
Yes.
We get pretty good support from Moynihan's and Reading Lumber.
Oh, that's good.
Lowe's.
That's great.
Good.
All right.
Thanks, Will.
Thanks.
Okay, Kylie Drive, they are postponing till next week. There is some issue with density, I guess, and I think we discussed the pool was too close to the
mm-hmm.
house, and some of our other town officials, planning in particular, are of the opinion that they need to move the hot tub from the driveway out of the trail, the existing trail, the way it's shown mm-hmm. currently, which we had talked about mm-hmm. that, but we got some backing on that, which is great.
Have they found out anything about moving the electrical box that's there to facilitate that better?
I don't know.
So the only conversation was that they need to talk to the building inspector and the town assistant town manager backed up exactly what the commission said, which is, you know, we have the right.
Mm-hmm.
We're in charge of the entire width of the
right
easement.
Yep.
So not just what we need. And then the assistant planning agent also said the same thing. I didn't hear anything, and then I got a request to continue. So they're going to come in with something different, but we don't know what it is yet.
Another item, we had received, I think, a preliminary plan for Low Meadow Arcadia Way, and they aren't ready for next week. We did think that they were coming in. We will hear from Randall Road next week. And the
so we did the Ann Rand Randall Roads.
Forget?
So this is not about wetland line at all, but it's about everything else.
Yeah,
the stormwater.
The project's actually being
yeah.
proposed.
So is it an NOI? Is it an NOI?
Oh, it has to be.
Yes.
It's a notice of intent, and they're being creative with their stormwater.
Do you know about these systems, Filtrex system?
It's a Filtrex box with a tree in it, charcoal liner, and it gets, I'm being told it's getting 80% through one unit before the discharge into a well.
I don't offhand. I mean, if you.
We'll have it checked out, yeah.
Yeah.
So.
Well, you're talking to somebody from.
We're sending out that packet tomorrow because, you know, the meeting's next week, and you'll see what's in there. You'll be able to check it out. I just didn't know how this agenda was going, so I couldn't. I have to let this meeting has to be done before I can do another agenda and send it out.
And just so that everybody knows, Chuck is not here next week.
Where am I? I'm not here next week.
Okay.
So Al, me.
Well, I better find out who's gonna be around.
So the only thing I'll tell you, and it should be fine, but I'm flying back from Florida Wednesday morning. So.
You know, we went back and forth a lot whether we should have a meeting or not with me on here, so. It's.
Yeah.
Right now we're having a meeting, but it's no one's crying if it doesn't happen.
I'm not in the country.
Is there a lot on the agenda?
Nice.
Well,
Sounds like it's just.
There's
Kylie Drive. Kylie Drive.
Kylie Drive, right.
I have a question.
And Acadia?
No, that's, they're not ready. I'm sorry, Dave, what?
Do we hear anything back about Perfectos?
No, they're, I have driven past and the berm's in, the granite berm's in, and they have down their binder course. So I'm gonna call up Andy and find out if he's coming in next week or when is it gonna start to happen, because he said he wouldn't do it until that comes in.
Anything else we can discuss?
Oh, so we've got to wait until 7:40.
We should send out an email just after the meeting, just for next, make sure, just in case. And
yeah,
Anika may not be able to make it.
Right.
We may be questionable whether we.
I know.
Is Al in Florida or something?
Yes, he is. So.
It was his birthday or something, and he goes down there for a couple of weeks every year around that time.
Ooh.
We'll find out.
Yep. The continued enforcement order for 218 Salem Street, why is that on the agenda?
It's on the agenda until, I mean, I could take it off the agenda, but it's on the agenda until we close it out. And it's likely now that the owners have come back from Nepal that they'll come into a meeting and they'll tell us that that work is done, which it is, that was under the enforcement order. We can close that out and just leave the notice of intent open, or at least give us permission to do that, and they don't have to come to a meeting. So that might be something where we should go to a site visit to check it out. So if you're ready to close out on the enforcement order part.
The work under the enforcement order was?
To move that retaining wall, to grade out the area,
yep.
To build the retaining wall where it's going.
Yeah, the existing one. Or the
and
replace.
That was that,
yep.
Except there was supposed to be some invasive removal, which did not happen. So that could be part of the notice of intent. So that part doesn't matter. We left the enforcement order open so they could get started right away.
That's right. Okay. Yeah, that call. Okay.
All right. I'll put it on a site visit.
We need to sign orders of condition?
Yes.
We do.
Waiting.
Are we waiting for a certain time?
Yeah, 7:40.
Oh. I don't think we've ever been ahead of time.
We are. Just flying along today, tonight.
What about the 147 Pearl Street?
That's 7:40.
Yeah, 7:40.
They're not here yet.
Well.
You guys got my notes on that, right?
Yes.
Site visit?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, it's 7:20. Did everyone have an opportunity to read the order of conditions? I had just a couple comments. That one, there's a, on number four and the third line, it says removal of invasive, but it doesn't say vegetation, so I just had Chuck put the vegetation in. And remember there was a, they're talking about on A1 putting in the bounds at the 25 foot, and I was asking Chuck if it would be acceptable for them to put one of those, I think we give those little square things out to put on the fence that they have back there, and I thought that that was okay. Right, Chuck?
Yep.
Yep.
Okay.
That's for Shackford.
Yes. And so, Chuck, do you have that ready for us to sign?
I do. So that last bit was, we're going to have the bounds, or we're not going to have the bounds on Shackford.
Well, I thought that they could put those.
The owls.
What are they?
Owls. But the owls.
I don't know what they are.
They usually do granite bounds.
The plaques.
The little plaques that we have.
Yeah.
To put on the fence that they have in the back there.
Okay.
Instead of putting in granite bounds.
Right.
Yeah.
Ah.
Because it's a
I was thinking of it for the next one, but yeah, okay. No,
well,
no.
The same thing. Well,
yeah.
We've talked about
yeah,
that.
Yeah,
we'll
yeah, 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 yeah. But okay, plaques at the fence on the back of the yard.
Right.
Because they've got the fence that's right along the.
Right.
Yeah, that makes sense.
Do I have a motion?
So you want to look at it before you. So there's the fence, which is, you know, just a few feet away, and I guess the 25 foot line would be right there. So Shackford, they didn't have a problem with the granite bounds.
Oh, they didn't?
Nope, they didn't. They didn't have a problem at all about any of that. The fence.
So we have it where it changes direction, right? Like, how many would we require? I guess there's
why
an aspect.
Why wouldn't you just have two?
Well, exactly. So there's an aspect of this, like.
Put it on the side and the side.
Two. And be done with it.
Yeah.
And now it's not, it's out of the way. It's not.
Kids aren't running into it.
Yep.
Yeah. That's kind of my concern.
Are we back to granite bounds?
Yeah. I think
at either end of the.
Yeah.
Yeah.
On either side of the property boundary. So I need to close this and then.
Make a
we didn't close it.
It's yes, you'd have to close and then vote
to
close and vote to issue.
Right.
You want to ask for public comment?
No.
I make a motion to close notice of intent 270-0671 for 45 Shackford Road.
Second.
All those in favor?
I make a motion to approve the order of conditions. For notice of intent 270-0671, 45 Shackford Road.
As amended.
Second.
All those in favor?
Harry, did you second twice?
Yes, I did.
You did.
Thank you.
is just going to let you know that Arcadia Ave was going to come in for November 9th, and so they're going to do a house, two-car garage, and a driveway. They're going to be pretty much right on the 35-foot line, and how they're going to do that is still a mystery. I haven't really seen any plans or anything like that, I've been told. So I was going to talk about that, but now it's not coming in on the 9th.
No,
they're not coming
next
in on the 9th either?
The 26th.
Well, if they can get it here via the 26th, they'll be in here on the 9th. Yeah, so they're not coming in on the 26th. I guess we're expecting them in on the 9th, I guess, is where we're at. And then, 364 Lowell Street. If anyone was here, don't think so. Maybe you were here for that, 364 Lowell Street. It's a subdivision that's right next to an intermittent stream that runs straight across Lowell Street and then underneath the railroad tracks, and you would be in the baseball fields of Austin Prep. So
is that the upper Jordan River?
That is not right there. That might be the Abitona goes through that this area. No,
okay.
No. The most fascinating thing about this, I guess, is, you know, there's an existing house there. They're going to modify and add a garage too. There's a stormwater structure that is kind of like a rain garden in this one. So it's been pretty much approved on our last meeting. So that whole application came almost all the way through the Conservation Commission, and it was just because they were worried about the findings of a vernal pool that they withdrew, and they didn't know which way the commission was going to go on that. Now Will, who was just here, and myself and their consultant, which was Bill Manuel, spent, I don't know, 5 hours out there in that pond, and we were looking. This was right in the time that you would find, I guess, some eggs and any kind of sign. We found one wood frog that was dead, but nothing else. And then so we submitted that application to Natural Heritage, and they denied it because it didn't support a vernal pool. There wasn't enough evidence. And I guess there was some recordings of bird chirping the wood frogs, and that wasn't enough either. So that's something to talk about, but I think that the commission who sat last time had spent a lot of time trying to figure out whether there was one there or not, and actually went forward with some paperwork. So, you know, it can't be talked about. You can go down and check it out yourself. But there wasn't anything there 2 years ago.
And that will be on this?
They are not going to say that there was a vernal pool out there.
No. That's going to be on the November 26th.
26th, yeah. So you have to take a consensus of all the clocks in the room.
What?
You take a consensus of all the clocks in the room, and then you can.
We just got.
go to the board.
At 7:30, same time. Did this is 26 Mile Post Road, order conditions, did everybody have an opportunity to review that?
Mm-hmm.
I did not, but.
So I had just the similar comment to you about the bounds and in regards to this is one where a little bit different from that wall, I guess not really that different. They don't really have a spot to put them on the edges because of the fence, the bounds would be like right in the middle of the yard. But so as we just discussed, it sounds like we can get some snow but make it flush with the ground so it's not something that's sticking up in some
straight
line.
Yeah.
Something that somebody will kill themselves.
And again, number four, the invasive vegetation. That's all I have. Do I hear a motion to close 26 Mile Post Road?
Make a motion to close notice of intent 270-0670, 26 Mile Post Road.
Do I hear a second?
Second.
All those in favor?
Motion to issue order of conditions for NOI 270-0670, 26 Mile Post Road.
Second.
All those in favor?
If anyone wants to go and check it out, the builder for 14 Covey is starting tomorrow. Just FYI. And he's the one that was doing the helical piles instead of digging the
Manny
footings.
Silva?
Because he has 12. Yeah, Manny.
Yeah.
That's
okay.
Right.
No.
Oh. I know what you're talking about. Yeah, update. I sent that and it came back to me and I will send it out again tomorrow. But it wasn't their fault, it was my fault. I had insufficient postage on it.
What number of Lowell Street is that development you were talking about?
364 Lowell.
360?
364.
364.
364 Lowell. Let's see if we can take a look at that.
But Covey Lane house, the re-digging and replacing in the foundation columns that was there for that porch. That was in the Deck Builder magazine. It was a feature article.
Which one?
The Covey Lane. The remember they had rebuilt the foundation piers under
right.
the room?
Right.
That was in Deck Builder's
That's
magazine.
Because that builder writes
right.
for these. Yeah. I talked to him. Yeah.
Oh. Did he tell you that that was in there?
He said that he wrote a lot of articles and he got a lot of work that way during the recession actually.
So that's 364 right there. It's in between Plymouth and Dustin.
Okay.
And there's two houses in this area here. This is dry. There's one house here, which was the, this was closest to the area that had a pond.
Yep.
So that we're worried about the vernal pool with that house. And then there's just the existing house that's going to get the garage. I'll turn on the can see. And it's pretty much like that because there's a shop bank right there.
Right.
It's like 1 foot away from the top of the bank is old growth pine trees.
Right.
So, yeah, it's like two feet up, 18 inches up, and then so it's pretty defined. So that's that one. And talk about artist. Maybe we can do that for a second. So I went out to the old Gary's greenhouse, but it's Artist Senior Living now, 1100 Main Street. And we've been doing final inspections. I don't know, I've done 5 already. And everything was going pretty good until the sod was rolled out. The sod was rolled out beyond the 25-foot line and right up the edge of the pond. And there's really not much room there. And when you go out there and you see it, and you gotta make a judgment call about how they're gonna park, how they're gonna walk next to an area, because the 25-foot is pretty much 6 inches away from the sidewalk. So our regulations would have it
25-foot?
Yeah. 25-foot. So they got a variance for a lot of this stuff because there were 3 separate ponds and they did all the work to combine those ponds so they'll flow. So it was one pond was isolated. They were all isolated. So they put a weir in and they brought down the soil and did some planting. So they got a variance for a lot of this work and being close, and this is one of the areas where they're very close. So we decided to get a split rail fence up and establish that split rail fence about 10 feet away from the top of the bank of that pond, and put the granite bounds in on the 25-foot line. So those will be there. The split rail fence will be in back of it. They're not going to mow in back of the fence, but the sod is still there right now. So that's one thing. The other thing is around back, they keep the back of that area completely encapsulated with a fence because people are out there walking around and they really have to be in this fenced in area. So this 8 foot high.
I'm sorry, so the fence is around the pond or around the
recreation
area?
Now we're talking about
area.
The fence around
where people can
attaches
go outside.
To the building on either side.
I got it.
And there's a courtyard out there with a walking path.
Okay.
But we're still close to the pond. Yeah. They put that on the wrong side of the 25-foot line. So it was 18, 17 feet away. And it's not shown that way on the plans. So there was really no other decision but to tell them to move it. So they're going to put the fence on the right side, just as it shows on the plan, and there's some planting that's missing just on the other side of that. So, I mean, we're still working with this group to close that out.
What was their reasoning for putting that in the wrong location?
I don't, I think that, I think it's just one of those things that just happened. I don't think there was an intent involved.
Right.
There didn't seem to be a change order. The people that are going to fix the fence right now are the ones that installed it. So the company, Delbrook Construction, is just passing it on to them to do the fix. So this is the ponded area, and I'll zoom in on that. And here's the driveway, and so they're trying to establish at least a 10-foot area to be natural vegetation around this pond. This isn't a great visual of what's really going on there. I don't
know. That cul-de-sac is elevated, right? Relative, everything back there is retaining.
Yeah. That's new. No, that's not a new one.
Well, so it appears the fence was put in just like geometrically what looked right It's right off the corner of the building, so it kind of looks like it fits where they put the fence.
Mm.
The fence looks like it's placed correctly relative to the shape of the building and the corner of the building, not...
Not to the plan.
Not to the plan, or not to the 25-foot line.
Placed it based on the plan, but just where it made sense, so
yeah.
But any visual, this
yeah.
must be right.
So they're fixing the fence around this building here as per the plan, and we had to do some modifications to what's here. So I suggest that you all drive past, and I know Dave has already, and check it out. I'm sure the fence is in already. And if you have any comments, let me know. The one I'm really interested in is if you think we should pull up the sod on the other side of the fence and cast out some upland seed mix or something like that.
When did this come before the commission? And that did I want to, a long time ago?
I
mean, this was before me.
Before me.
Okay.
Yeah. It was, yeah, this...
2 years ago? Two, three?
Yeah.
Two and a half?
Okay.
All right.
We're ready for the next item on the agenda, 147 Pearl Street, and this is a public hearing for, let's see, oops, where's my agenda? Oh, thank you. Notice of intent 270-0672, 147 Pearl Street, map 28, lot 207, Stoughton. It's now open and being conducted concurrently under the authority of the Massachusetts Wetlands Protection Act, Massachusetts General Laws, Chapter 131, Section 40, as amended in the Reading General Bylaws, Section 7.1. The hearing is conducted in the following manner. The applicant or the applicant's representative will present the project. Commission will receive reports from our administrator, technical advisors, other town departments, and the commission, members of the commission will address questions and comments to the applicant, and then the public will be given the opportunity to ask questions of the applicant, but it should be directed to the chair. I'm the chair. So I would like everyone to, did everyone sign in? There's a sign-in sheet. And at this time, I'd like to introduce members of the Conservation Commission, starting on my right.
David Pinnett.
Harry Curtis.
Rebecca Longley, Chair.
Michael Flynn.
Chuck Tironi, Conservation Administrator. I just noticed you're in front of Al's nameplate. I'm not sure if that matters to you.
Do I have one?
But you could change it.
Yeah, yours is right there. Yeah, right there.
I'm here?
Yeah. Very good.
I suppose he's watching.
No, unless ship to shore.
No, he's out drinking someplace. But sorry, this is yours. Okay, got one. Are you the applicant's representative?
I am, and this is her fiance. My name's Keith Shearer.
Okay.
Todd Protz. I'm the builder.
Okay.
I'm going to build the garage for
him. I didn't catch your name.
Todd Protz.
Hi.
Last name's P-R-O-T-Z.
Thank you. Do you want to tell us what you're proposing on at the site?
Duffy's looking to, in the back right-hand corner of her property, put a 24-by-24 garage and a proposed pool directly behind her house. It's within the buffer zone, and I met with Glenn, the building inspector, today on all the setbacks and everything and the coverages, and we have satisfied his questions this morning. He didn't have any problems with any of the coverages or setbacks.
I didn't hear from him, but I can certainly get an email from him if he's talked about this. I knew that it came in this morning.
Yeah, yeah.
So, but I didn't hear anything after that.
He had a couple of requirements on the plot plan that you're viewing here, just some information that wasn't on there that he requested that I had changed, and we did. It just added information to this.
And what can you be more specific on what he was looking for?
I have another copy of this here, too, if you want to. It's just notes on there.
Mm-hmm.
The zone, the max lot coverage required, existing and proposed. The max coverage of ground structures in the rear yard setback, and the square footage of the proposed garage in the rear yard as well. Those things that he asked to be on this, that was added. It's not on that copy, but I have it on this copy here that he asked me that the changes be on there when I submitted for the permit.
Did he say that you met the maximum lot coverage?
Yes.
He just wanted
it written out there. He actually sat with me this morning and we did the math, and he said it looks good, he goes, but I want it from the engineer.
Right.
With the stamp. So
yep.
He changed it today and put it on the first revision on here. Would anyone like to see a copy? I have a copy here.
So one thing the commission should notice is that when Glenn reviews a pool, he goes from the water line, not from the concrete apron. So you'll see those measurements at the water line, 7 feet, and I think I can't read the other one, 8 or 5 feet, whatever it says. Looks like it says 8 feet. So that's just how building handles that. We would handle it from the edge of the apron.
So you didn't stamp, you're not the PE who
no.
stamped this? Okay.
No. A gentleman by the name of Richard Mead.
Okay. A couple things that come to mind when I'm looking at this plan is you've got a 10-foot ZNV buffer zone. That's really your 35-foot no structure zone. You see that?
Yeah.
Yeah, so that's incorrectly labeled. The other thing, we did take an inspection on Sunday morning. What I'd like to know is what is the existing impervious surface and what is your increase in impervious surface? And that would be the square footage of, you know, your asphalt, your building, the pool apron, and the garage.
Okay.
So what's existing now, which is a driveway over to the right in the house.
Yeah.
And
you want to know what the total will be in the end?
What it is now, what the existing is, and
yeah.
then the increase.
And the increase.
Yeah.
Okay. I don't know that off the top of my head.
Right. You'd have to measure
math,
that.
But,
yeah.
Is the existing driveway coming out? I'm sorry. Is that true?
The existing driveway is not coming out. It's not planned to. I could do the math.
I mean, you're not going to be able to do that right now.
Yeah, so
now.
we're gonna need you to just add that to the list for the engineer to change the language on where it says 10-foot ZNV to 35-foot no build.
Yeah.
And then we're asking for existing and proposed imperviousness on the site.
What's the proposed new driveway to the garage? What's the proposed finished surface to the new
asphalt.
Garage?
And also, we typically require some kind of infiltration because you're increasing the impervious surface. So you might want to talk to your PE about that. And you don't have anything like that now. Do you have some gutters on the house?
There is, yeah.
Okay.
And there will be gutters on the garage as well.
Okay.
The gutters just run off onto the ground?
They do currently.
So do you need that driveway that's going to the, I'm gonna say,
kind of a
deck porch area on the?
Deck.
Well, that's an, that, it's, it, the driveway shown, that's actually an addition off the side. It actually goes underneath it.
Mm-hmm.
So
you, would you consider removing that to reduce the imperviousness in that area closest to the?
Removing the other driveway where your air conditioning is located now, where your toolbox went in the?
Yeah, no worries. Yeah, I'd have to get everything out of there. It's kind of used as a
well,
storage compound, but everything's gonna be moved if we
right.
get the other side. So yeah, we could, I'd have to talk to the wife about that, but obviously we can definitely
yeah.
address that.
What did I miss?
So we had three things. So we had the total, the increase in the impervious surface, which is pretty significant on this project. So we're trying to think of every way we can to help you reduce that,
yeah.
reduce the impact of the runoff. Second is infiltration. So some way of, as we're increasing the impervious surface, you know, if you can run some gutters into something underground that enters the water into the soil instead of running
storage off. Tank would be needed or not?
Well, there's different options.
Dry wells
yeah.
in the ground.
Yeah.
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 Like a shea shallow pit.
And then the third thing we had was, as you're looking at removing the two trees where the garage is going,
right.
where you're removing the two trees where the garage is going,
yeah.
we're going to plant.
Is you're going to need to replace those in some fashion. And
right, for everyone you remove, you've got to plant.
Yeah, yeah. And
what that's stated on here as well?
Well, it will be in the order of conditions. So
okay.
the way that would work is when this is approved, you'll be able to do your project, and then when it's done, you're going to be asked for an as-built plan.
Sure.
So we'll ask that engineer to locate the trees because we wanted them planted, and then
okay.
we're going to need an update for 2 years on those trees to let us know that they're still alive. And those trees are going to have to be native trees. So when you get your order of conditions, we'll have a list of native trees that'll come with that, and you can just pick it off that list or give it to your landscaper.
Okay.
Do you also know, we also saw the stream in the town of Reading easement, and it looked like it had been channelized. Do you know who did that or when it was done?
They just purchased the house recently.
Oh.
Channelized?
Yeah, everything there was there when they got there. Even the vinyl fence is all there as well.
Did you find out who?
I didn't talk to who would that have been? I didn't talk to Mike Hannaford, who works with the tree warden, but I know that a branch or a tree had fallen down in that area, and a couple months ago, maybe a little bit more, but not too much more, and they had to get in and take care of it. So I don't know if someone tried to allow the stream to go through.
It's a very strange thread of the stream. Take some odd angles. Yeah.
That's a full stream? I don't know the lay of the whole. To me, it looks like a drainage ditch.
That's what it is.
Yeah,
it is,
okay.
But it has vegetation alongside it, and so it is a resource area.
Well, okay. Yeah, it's drawn quite funny on the plan, too. If you look at the way it's drawn, it's a very crooked layout. If you look at the blue line all the way to the top right,
yep.
that's the lay of the drainage ditch.
That's the lay of the vegetation, because there are flags out there, and they were flagged by a consultant.
Yep. Yeah,
we did observe those. Yeah. Are there any other questions from?
No, I just wanted to make a clarification.
Yeah.
So when you talk to the engineer about infiltration, you need to infiltrate for all the new impervious surfaces, so the garage, the driveway, and the pool. And I don't know what that's going to look like, but at least try to get that all done. So you could have some dry wells around the garage, and you could also just install them around the house too. So we're just looking for a number, not, you know, you don't have to come up with something around the driveway. Can just use the house.
Okay.
Any other questions from the commission?
You know, as you're thinking about the trees, it's good if you can put them on the plan. Just makes everything go easier. Okay.
And, right?
Sure.
Location.
So they're located on the proposed?
The new trees.
Yeah, the proposed trees, we see the ones to be removed.
And you've got the flexibility to put them on the lot and play, you know, they're shading what will be the pool now.
Yep.
So as you're thinking about where you put your trees and how tall they're gonna get over time.
Yep.
If you don't want shade on your pool, then you might wanna think about putting them somewhere else, got different options there for what you wanna do.
Right.
So we just encourage you to think that through, get it all approved at once and then you're done.
Okay, so we've gotta come back to get it for another meeting before we can build?
Yeah.
Yes.
You'd at least have two meetings.
Yeah.
Yeah. I talked to Stephanie about that and I told her how that process works.
Okay.
So I won't go through it here, but basically you can't write the order before we hear about the project.
Yep.
So between this meeting and the next, if the commission feels that they're close enough to that, they'll ask me to write the order. So at the next meeting you can, you would be able to pick that up.
Okay.
Are there any comments from?
Excuse me. Is there an appeal period after the next meeting as well?
Yes.
There's a 10-day appeal period, and with a notice of intent, you can't work until that's over. So, I mean, you could order your stock. Are you waiting to put in your building permit? No, right? That should be.
I am waiting to put the permit in. I want to make sure I have all of Glenn's changes, which I got done today.
Yeah.
And I'll get your changes as well on this plan.
Unless you're moving the pool, and downsizing the garage and the driveway, I mean, the changes that we come up tonight are all we want.
Yeah.
You'd have to show what we want, what Glenn asked for, to back to him, and then present us with a new plan, or get me a new plan before the next meeting.
When's the next meeting?
It's going to be the 26th.
Next Wednesday.
Next Wednesday?
We have the 26th or November 9th.
When do they need to get the information back to you?
I'll get it as fast as I can.
That's up to you. We usually don't accept things early, but you've looked at this and you've also asked them
mm-hmm.
what you want, so it might not take you too long to review it. But if we could get the stormwater calculations emailed to us as soon as he figures out how much recharge he's doing for the imperviousness, then we could review that at least, and you could email me, copy that, and email and copy the plan. So it really is all about how fast the engineer can turn out some numbers and a new
plan. Changes for me in an hour this morning, so.
Sounds like
helpful.
You got the right guy working for
you.
Yeah.
So I'll get him, I will talk to him tomorrow and get him right on it.
Are there any?
Yeah.
Okay.
And is there an email address for the commission?
She does, but it, you could either give me a card or I could give you my card. No.
I don't have one on me, but I'll take yours.
Okay.
Do you have any comments, questions?
Yeah, but so my comments.
Nick, can you introduce yourself?
Oh,
to
sure.
Everybody?
Patrick Mannion. I live at 126 Charles Street. I live behind Keith and Stephanie.
Right in the back area.
Right in the back area over here.
Well,
so
right.
I'm no issue with the proposed pool, but I am concerned about the driveway and the garage.
Okay.
I think as it would concern the Conservation Commission, my concern is that the trees that are being removed right now, as you noted, we lost some trees up on the top of Pearl Street where the stream is, that actually gave us a great deal of privacy from the folks that are, if you were looking at your house to the left of you, so essentially from Pearl and the neighbors, you can essentially look right down into our yard now because Pearl is elevated. And we're gonna lose some more trees now with the garage, which essentially provide us with a great deal of privacy and shade in the backyard, depending on the time of day. In addition, with Pearl Street being elevated, I'm concerned about the water runoff that's both coming off the driveway and essentially going into our backyard where our patio is. And then I'm concerned about the water runoff coming off of the garage, which is going to be a pretty large structure and should capture a decent amount of rain. I understand you were talking about putting some drainage in.
That's why we're asking for infiltration and why we want to know what the increase in the impervious surfaces
okay.
are.
Okay.
We are asking, we have a policy now, a tree replacement policy, and because that's, within our jurisdiction, those trees, we are asking for some kind of a one-to-one replacement, not, certainly not a huge tree. It's going to be a sapling that they would plant, and or a shrubbery. Or in we also allow funds to be, instead of planting, they are allowed to provide funds for tree replacement in the town of Reading.
Understood. Okay. All right.
You'll gain a little bit of privacy having the garage, the backside of the garage.
Right.
You'd be looking at a gable in the middle.
Okay.
What's a proposed roof for the garage?
Excuse me?
Proposed roof. Is it gable? Is it hip? What kind of roof is it?
Gable front to back. The gutters will be on down left and right side looking at the front of the garage.
Sorry. Just give him a little more privacy. I just want to trying to get it.
So you're gonna look gable, so you're looking at the garage, it's
yeah,
that where
the
gable is right there.
I was just trying to think of where the fall
snow
off
loads
the gutters are gonna go.
Yeah.
Head of the garage is 17'7". It's pretty tall.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Maybe we can mark some trees
we
in that
place,
area.
We can place those trees
somewhere
you might like them.
Yeah.
So because of the grade that's there's a pretty steep grade that goes from Pro Street down to where the garage is. You might want to consider putting some kind of an infiltration trench in front of the garage doors and then discharge your gutters down on either side of the roof into that same discharge area and then put that into infiltration. If you do put it in the backyard chamber or something.
Any other questions, comments? Do I hear a motion to continue?
Make a motion to continue. 147 Pearl Street, NOI 70672.
Second.
All those in favor?
One second. Now, before you, you're just continuing on issuing.
We're just continuing.
Why?
I want some direction about whether you want me to write this or not. Do you feel like how information is going to get to you will allow you enough time to review it? So I should go ahead and write the order.
You know, I think I don't have a problem with you writing the order, but I think I want to be comfortable about the stormwater calculations for the infiltration.
I would agree. I think it's fair enough to write the order if the stormwater calcs come in or the infiltration calcs come in and we still have issues. It doesn't mean that we necessarily still have comments for the next meeting. But at least we're prepared if everything, you know, we've got a pretty straightforward list here, so at least we're prepared for the next meeting if that's the case.
Yep, that's what we can do. Okay, so I'll write it, and it's all about getting the material to us quickly.
Yep.
So we would definitely need everything from here forward emailed to me and paper copies.
And paper copies?
How many paper copies? Well, we usually ask for seven.
Seven?
Does anyone want the stormwater calculations hard copy, or is it good enough to get them?
It's fine with me.
Email's
fine.
Did you hear that? We just want plans, and you can email us the stormwater calculations.
The next meeting, do you want the proposed infiltration plan for the next
that
meeting?
Should, yeah, the,
yeah.
The
yeah.
plan's
yes.
going to have all that.
Yeah.
It's going to have the trees, it has to have figure out the runoff of the driveway, infiltration, where it's going, show us what kind. You know, it's going to be maybe another page on those plans.
Okay.
I mean, your engineer can give me a call if he wants a little bit more detail of what we're looking for.
That'd
be fine.
Great.
So we don't work Friday, but I will be here all day tomorrow.
Okay. Yeah, I'll call him first thing in the morning.
Great.
Okay.
I'm going to talk with you.
Okay.
That's it? Okay.
Very well.
Thank you very much.
Thank
you.
Thank
you.
You
too. We appreciate it.
Thank you.
Let me just let me just get your phone number. Let me do that.
781-223-292.
And I'll give you a call in the morning and we'll just trade emails and send you something. Right?
Great. Thank you very much.
Thanks.
Have a great night, y'all.
Great.
Thank
good
you.
Night. Good suggestions.
You're a good teacher.
Not me.
Yeah, you.
Okay. Do we have anything else? What else have we got?
No, 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 I have home in time for the debate, frankly. I'd like to just be here until like 11. That's okay.
You can stay.
I didn't see this until after. That's the driveway too, huh?
No.
No?
Oh.
To the left of the house there is.
That's,
yeah.
So I was asking about the one to the left of the house, but there's a circular one in the front?
Yes, right in the front, right on Pearl Street.
That's right.
There's a semi-circular driveway right in front of the house.
Yeah, there's a lot of driveways over there.
It's going to be a very hard one to inter all the extra water.
We do have a pretty big, you know, pretty big grass area, though, to the left side of the house in the back.
Yeah,
from
the
where the pool is to the drainage ditch.
But you got the pool, the driveway, the garage.
Right.
Yeah.
Well, they were going to take out that driveway that goes to the...
He said he was going to check.
Yeah, not certain. I know the people, there's a storage area that's under...
Yeah, we saw that,
thing,
yeah.
So, that they, I know
that
they
may
do
be
use.
One of their only options.
So I didn't see that until afterwards. Because I just noticed the existing one that was to the left there. I just wanted to confirm that one.
I've forgotten. You're right.
But if they have, you know, the calculations and they'll infiltrate enough to account for the new driveway, the garage, and the pool,
right?
You're not changing anything.
No, I just think that's hard because
yeah.
the pool, you know, it's a little deceptive on here, but there's a triangular patio next to the pool. They're just covering up a lot.
Yeah.
So it's not going to be the easiest one in the world for them to.
But you want to nix the whole project because the
no, no, I'm
between
just, no.
the back door and the
no,
front.
That's why they need to,
you know,
do some math.
Yeah.
So I have the modified enforcement order for North Reading. It was something that we agreed on, but it has to be ratified by the commission. And it just gives him instructions on what he can do. And we talked about parking in Bob's pond and using a staging area. You know, at least 100 feet away, and then notice. Mike Sorehand. I talked to him today on the phone, and all of the construction is done, except for some non-structural work that he'd like to talk to me about. So this can't be closed out right now. It's likely there's going to be a little bit more time. There's probably a little bit of money left, so he wants to get some other things taken care of. So that's
yeah,
it.
I went by.
So I would, can I just pass this around for people to sign?
Mill Street today, and there's quite a bit of water.
Mm.
You know, maybe 6 inches. Yeah, you know, underneath the
mm-hmm.
road. Yeah, I think they did that work last week because I saw, you know, a sign on the road that comes off of 93, you know, Concord Ave.
Weren't they supposed to tell us when they were doing the work?
Yeah, were they supposed to tell us?
So we had...
You have
we
something
just
on your keyboard that's pushing a button down?
No.
A little peanut butter in there?
I don't know.
must mean the debate started.
Yeah.
Yeah. Someone's sensing, is there too much turn? I don't know what's going on here. Did this a couple of weeks ago too. Well, I was trying to, so I was out and about today. Let me shut this off. I don't know what's going on here. I was out and about today and I noticed, and I don't know if you guys ever sense this kind of stuff, but I've been walking down the road and I see right on Eaton Street a storm drain, and it's clean on the top, but all around the side is cement stuck to the steel storm drain. So somebody went over there and cleaned out, you know, a cement truck or something like that, and it's kind of a private area, and it was direct discharge right into the wetlands. So I looked down there and I didn't see it. I didn't see any residue, so it couldn't have been lately. But that's too bad.
At the
That's just down the street from Green Street,
yeah.
And between, what is it, Salem? But there's that swamp, that wetland stretch where there's no houses on either side, just before you get to the park. It was done right there.
So there was a transformer that went out and looked like the pole went not that long ago, and there was a lot of utility work, emergency utility work going on.
Oh, really?
Mm-hmm. It was maybe 2 months ago.
RMLD?
I don't know.
So I'm gonna follow up on that. I have a contact over there. What do you think the cement would be of use for another pad for another transformer? Well, a transformer could be up in there.
Yeah, so I don't know. If I go by, I could probably see about where it was if that's the same area.
Yeah.
But,
I was surprised. I mean, I've always heard of that happening, but I didn't think anyone ever did that. So, I am really a patient guy, but we're waiting for a certain time, right? That's what we're doing?
No, we're not gonna. I called, there's an enforcement order. When was this? Not last week, the week before I heard, no. I thought it was on the other side of Summer Ave on the uphill side of Bear Hill, but I got in my car and I drove up to 28 and saw a huge crane four houses up, but there's also wetland in the back of my house. There's a stream that goes under Ash Street into the huge wetland area. I don't know where the wetland was, but I called Chuck and said, you know, I think there's work going on and it's close to wetlands. Well, he came down and there were two people that were removing trees. There were three trees that were outside of our jurisdictional area and two trees inside. Mm-hmm. One was a pine, one was a, what was the other one?
I forgot. Maple?
I don't know. What? And I guess the pine was semi-compromised, but the other one was healthy. So, you know, Chuck tried to talk to them, but the gentleman who owned the crane company was out of New Hampshire. But the person whose job it was my neighbor four houses down from me, who's actually done work for me. And, you know, I know him pretty well, so. I called him and he came over and I gave him permits, the minor permit and RDA permit, and I asked Chuck to print out our tree replacement policy, and I went through it with him. And basically, I think the disconnect with these guys are that they tell the homeowner, oh, you're in charge of getting the permits, but they don't tell them, you know, what kind of permits they really need, because I don't think they understand it. In particular, the one from New Hampshire, but he was the one who owned the crane, and Dave, my neighbor, just rents that crane and works with him, but it was his job. So I really think it's his responsibility. So we sent out an enforcement order to David my neighbor, as well as the property owner. And what we would definitely be looking would be some kind of tree replacement. And we could fine the two of them, but what I kind of wanted to do was to really educate them. And so one of the things Chuck has been trying to figure out is how, when these big companies come in, how we can get notified. And one of the ways is they had to have a detail because they shut down. They had their equipment was out in Summer Ave and shut down the one of the lanes. So they had to have a police detail. So when the companies come in to get the detail, Chuck talked to the chief of police so that they will notify us when something like that happens. You know, then Chuck knows, and he can take a look at our GIS to see, you know, if it's high and dry or not.
Where was the resource area relative to the trees?
About 70 to 80 feet away.
Thanks.
Chuck?
To the trees?
Yeah. The resource area.
Yes.
Do you have a photo?
I don't have a photo. I was going to use...
Yeah.
I was going to use this, so I just shut it off. Let me try it again and see if I have too much stuff up here.
Has the commission at any time in the past notified all of the tree companies in Reading and all the abutting towns as to what the expectations are to do work in Reading?
There are a couple companies that know. Northeast Tree knows what they're doing, and who's the other one?
Polonsky?
No.
Hiking?
No.
No, it is Polonsky. So I have good contact with Polonsky Tree and Northeast Tree, good contract. And there's another...
Keneally?
No, there's another small group that are near that Pleasant Street, Wilson Street area. And it's like ASC or it might be ASC Tree Service. They're very responsible too, and they call.
Mm-hmm.
So... but we have blanketed the area with, when we first came out with our tree policy, we sent that out to everyone, and we sent it out again last year. So we've sent it out twice. So it must have been a year apart. So in 3 years, we sent it out twice. But I'm constantly calling people. You know, if I see a tree service, I'll just call them up and let them know, you know, about that, because it's the rule of thumbs that they come up with, that, you know, they can take down any tree. I don't know where this came from. It's like urban myth. You know, if it's close enough to someone's house, they can take it down without anyone's, you know, other approval. So that's just one of them, but there's several. And that's how they operate. They come in Friday, Saturday, Sunday, and they're probably doing some of this work.
Is there anything on the Conservation Commission website as to how to make a determination on who to contact? Is our tree policy currently on the website?
Yep. Our tree policy is on the website.
Because you know that some people, when they go and cut a tree, but it's not sitting in the swamp.
I don't.
You know.
Well, especially when you get... A lot of tree removal happens when somebody buys a new house.
Oh.
Right. So if you're a first-time homeowner, or if you just come to this country,
mm-hmm.
and you buy a house and you say, that tree needs to go, you cut it down.
Or if you're 80 feet away,
right.
You know, something like this.
Right.
You know, there's these ones where you say, oh, there's no, I'm so far away from.
Yeah.
And I think that is kind of on the hill.
Yeah.
And it goes down into Orton Dairy.
But, you know, take, for instance, the, I forget what the address was, but it was Passapia. They had a drainage ditch that went down the side of the yard where that questionable wetland was next door, and then it took a 90-degree bend where the fox den was in their backyard. Well, if their neighbor, one street, one house up, if
I
someone
just to show you the
bought
comments.
That house and had a tree that was in their front yard,
really?
In the corner
yeah.
of their house that was
mm-hmm.
impinging upon their structure. They said, well, I want to get rid of that. You know, they're calling a tree company. You know,
Didn't even know it was back there.
How is the tree company gonna know that there's a drainage ditch back there behind this brambles of trees? So, you know, that's the thing that.
I think what we're trying to convey to these companies is, you know, call Chuck. You know, just as a rule of thumb, and he'll take a look and say, you know, you may have some issues there, or you're free and clear.
Because it may, you know, very well, like I said, it's not a condition that's on their property, it's the neighbor's property.
Yep.
And it's still within, you know, 100 feet, so. That's a tough one.
It is a tough one, but, yep. Did you wanna talk about Dustin Road?
No, I wanted to know what we're doing about this.
Well, we've got nobody to talk to right now.
So what does that mean? Does that mean, so?
President and Chair, are you talking in code with this?
No,
the enforcement order on 582 Summer Ave.
Asked both people to come in tonight.
So we're gonna ask them to come in?
Well, did.
Okay.
I did.
They're not here.
They're not here.
So, we've got an enforcement order and
find them.
You know.
Chuck, can you zoom in a little bit on that just so that I can read the.
That's 62 mile.
I would like to see that they amend it and do the work that we would have requested, which is a replacement.
Well, that's mile post.
And if they still.
I was looking for the place where they cut the trees down.
We're not closing it. If they still haven't responded to that, then maybe we consider a fine, but until that time, at this point, I don't see a reason to find it.
Oh.
How the rest feel?
Sir?
I think if we had told somebody not to cut down the trees and they did it anyway, I'd fine them. I think if somebody hires a company from outside of the state we're able to plant a couple new trees. I think they ought to just hurry up and get to the commission.
Well, do we know that they're going to plant trees?
No, but the enforcement order stays open until.
Well, just because we don't issue a fine now doesn't mean we don't next week.
Yeah.
So for the size of the trees, would you go for the same thing for one for one? Or
no,
would you
that's
ask
not
for
part
more?
Of our. That's not part of our policy.
Okay.
It's we're pretty specific about. You know, the size of the tree that you can plant.
Mm-hmm.
We're not looking for
right.
You know.
But weren't these substantial sized trees that were cut down?
Yes. You should have seen the crane that they had to use, yeah. It's a couple thousand dollars a tree to do this work. It's not a cheap thing. They had 5 trees they were taking down, 3 outside of our jurisdiction, 2 in.
So for the 2 that were in, would you request more than 1 tree because of the size of the trees that were taken down for replacement?
That's not really part of our tree policy.
Right.
No.
Okay, so 1 for 1.
So we've already issued the enforcement order?
Yes, 2 of them.
Do we need to ratify it?
Yeah.
Do I hear a motion?
To
ratify the enforcement order.
How do we get them to the meeting? That's the lever. Do we say if you don't comply with the enforcement order and show up next week, then we'll fine you? Since you said you were going to come and you didn't, or we asked you to come and you didn't, or?
I don't.
Same type of hang out there forever.
I think when they don't show up, they're not going to show up. But, you know, you can always say it's your town. And they'll do what you want. I can
write. How do we get them? How do we get the property owner to plant 2 trees?
Well, in order to do anything, you need 2 willing parties, and to show someone's willingness, they would be at the meeting. So since that didn't happen, I think that you're not gonna get a tree planted.
So I'm going to pretend like I don't know your tone and just assume that they couldn't make the meeting and say, if you know, we've got a meeting next week, which is coincidental that we have 1-2 weeks in a row, and I would still give them the chance to come into and speak to this commission the following week.
No, I'm happy with it. Yeah. What?
I have a call in to the contractor.
Mm-hmm.
I left a message on his cell. Maybe I'll just go down to his house and rent tonight.
Yeah. So you know, actually, Mike, it could have been the week that I think was there 1 week that he said he wasn't going to be around.
He's also a bartender, and I don't know if he works on Wednesday night. So that's why I've got the call in to.
Yeah, give him another week.
And you know, I think the solution here, this isn't like some of the enforcement orders that we've seen, where the solution could be very complex, and there's a pretty straightforward solution here. I think we can talk about it. If they're not a willing participant, then I think there's steps we can take. But as of right now, I think we still give them the chance to come before us and take it from there.
I actually think, since, what did we said $250 a tree if you want to donate, right?
Sounds like a pretty easy way to find.
$250 a
if
tree.
If we needed to.
So if they don't come to the meeting next week, then we'll find them $500.
Right.
Let's
see what happens.
Yep. So do we still need to ratify the enforcement order?
I believe so.
I make a motion to ratify the enforcement order for 582 Summer Ave, the enforcement orders. If I can make a motion for two. One
I think so.
For
Murata and the other second for Costello.
Costello.
Second them both?
All those in favor?
I'm so relying on you to put me in the right spot here.
Yeah, you.
I like Chuck to put someone in his place, though.
No. Jeez.
So, I've been punny all day, can I tell you?
There is none.
Okay.
I don't know what they're talking about.
They usually don't comment, do they?
No, they comment when they want to.
What did I miss?
There was a comment on the 26-mile post, notice of intent from the DEP.
Oh. Well, I wondered what that was. I didn't have the context.
Label on the plan should be riverfront area, not buffer. Riverfront area is a wetland resource area with its own set of regulations that the applicant has not addressed. Intended for a different application, maybe?
So the same mile?
It's not working.
Up to a river?
Well, I had it kind of clear. Oh, there it is. On South Street.
Well, is it Al in a river too then? I'll just stir things up.
Skibble. Well.
This would be a vineyard.
Yeah, that's the lazy river right there that they're talking about.
The lazy river?
The lazy river, yeah. I would prefer to call DEP and ask them what they're talking about.
I'll let you take care of that tomorrow.
Which property are we
talking
about?
That would be a lot more satisfying. That's off for 26 Mile Post. So what they're saying there.
Where's 26 Mile Post on that map?
Oh, where is it?
Yeah, is it on there?
Yeah.
Right there.
And are we saying that is a river?
Yeah, saying that's a river.
That's what Mass DEP is saying.
Is that the one off of Popkins?
Hmm.
Okay.
Yeah, I don't even, I mean, I dragged this around, but I think it's going to stop flashing. I don't know where it goes over there. Well, that's Walnut Street. Seems to be pretty isolated.
Is this just a random check from DEP?
No, they're supposed to check everything. And sometimes they do, and sometimes they.
This is the first.
They could have been. They could be checking us. I mean, Jack didn't call him. I asked Jack what he thought about that, and he said he didn't even call. So what they're looking for is that riverfront multiplier. That's what I would think that they were doing. So they wanted more money. Well, when I've got these before, that's what it's all about. You guys, your calculation's wrong because it's riverfront and resource area, so you have to use the riverfront multiplier. So I guess you could check this out. It's the USGS map, and if it's a dark blue line, you know, that's probably where it came from. But that I wouldn't have called that a river.
Well, truth is, you can go down to that side street, crosses it. It's probably a culvert.
I think this commission's already made a motion. Anyways.
Take a look.
What am I looking for?
No, I'm not saying you should.
Oh, they should look. DEP?
Maybe they could look. I don't know.
You know what they should do? They should make a boat out of one of their enforcement orders, or their superseding orders, and they should put it in right at whatever this house is here. They should put it in at 45.
Is that Al's house?
Maybe Steve Erickson could get his kayak up there.
That's the wrong one, right?
And then they should pick it up right over here, and right here where you said at the bridge.
Yeah, 28 Haystack. That's got like the triangle on it there.
Man cave.
But that, yeah, no, that's certainly not, you know, what we thought. They could also put it in this house here. But that. Okay.
I can't imagine, based on the topography, that's got a watershed that would support.
Yeah, haven't we worked on that before? Were you around when we did a lot of watershed work on Arcadia and all that? Yeah, you were.
On Arcadia, yeah.
Yeah.
But I mean, this, if you think about it, this is up near the top of the hill.
I mean, I don't even know if I would waste my time looking at this, but you could. It's pretty easy to check that out. I don't think it has the watershed to support that. It's a mistake. It has to be. And if it meant, you know, $1,000, it probably would have. That multiplier based on what this is probably like $50.
All right.
Dustin Road?
We got more. These things weren't on here.
Dustin Road is just. I can tell you about where I was down at Dustin Road, but the other thing is, there's nothing there. Dustin Road, there's someone wants to take down a tree, had me come out, and it looks like he's going to donate $250 to the Shade Tree Fund to take down a red maple in front of his yard. He was actually thinking of leaving an 8 to 15 foot stack in front of his house, but the tree company talked him out of it. It's right next to the walkway. So. Anything else?
No. Do I hear a motion?
Do we have minutes?
No, we don't have minutes. You'll probably get some minutes tomorrow.
Were you doing the minutes or was Anika?
Just me. Oh, Anika's got one that she owes us, but mine are almost done. Although the meeting seemed light, I wanted to get this stuff done for the meeting. But a meeting like this with these minutes, this is not a problem. It was the last two. And if Randall Road and Arcadia come in, it's gonna be very tough to do those minutes also.
Mm-hmm.
So it just seems to generate so much work in between the weeks that we have our meetings, so.
Have you heard anything about Lakeview and Eaton?
That
one's gonna be a while.
They
right?
are back at the drawing board because the town requested them to look at the project and see if they could move some stuff and to I guess there was a thought about how the parking is there's so much parking with this. They wanted them to really try to figure out some different ways to park all those cars. And each unit only has parking underneath its foundation. But, I mean, you could expand that, out beyond the foundation. I mean, they hold the land. So I guess that came up. We had a DRT meeting and it was mostly about parking and where you're gonna, try to find some more parking, try to find some better parking.
Do they still go before the DRT even if they're doing
Yeah, they'll go, sometimes you can go a couple of times, I guess, how that works. It's the design review team.
Mm-hmm.
And a project like this, you'll ask a few questions based on the plans that you see, and they'll do that, and then maybe that, someone else didn't visualize what you're doing, and then when they come in the next time, they'll say, oh, now you gotta change something else. But we've had a couple. We've had a site visit. I've had a couple meetings. But they're close to getting something here. I mean, at least they thought they were close. And maybe this parking thing is, they have to rethink it a little bit, but I don't know when that's coming in, but it's definitely going to be a 40B.
Yeah.
So.
Okay.
Oh, one more thing. They didn't realize our no structure zone meant pavement. So, just imagine. So they got really close to the 23-foot line in the back.
So
that started the parking conversation.
If they're going with the 40B, I thought there was potential that they didn't even have to follow that.
Well,
yeah.
The way I asked them, the way I how I put it to them was, I don't even think you can say there's no alteration or damage that you're going to cause the wetland under the Wetlands Protection Act.
Mm-hmm.
Being that close. So, what are you thinking? Do you think,
I don't know if that would hold up with DEP. I just don't know. If they appealed it,
it's going to be under the bylaw, too.
I don't think you.
I talked to someone from DEP, and he had kind of what you're saying, which is a buffer zone project is and always will be approved. And I, you know, obviously we didn't agree on that, but when you're doing a denial, you have to find out, I mean, you have to say what interest of the act is being altered and why. So, and you could say in that spot, there's a lot of trees, and there is a lot of trees there. And those trees shade the brook and it cools the brook. Now, are those trees going to be there? I don't know. I don't know what the new thing looks like, but we're 20, I mean, it's likely that all that construction is going to kill those trees, and that's going to warm the brook up. And, you know, there's one thing right there.
First argument I would make is, well, it's not a brook, it's a man-made canal.
All right. I don't
oh,
see
no.
DEP.
So you don't think
no,
it has
no.
fish in it?
I don't see DEP.
Canals have fish in them.
Yeah, it's still a wetland.
So it's just not riverfront.
Yeah.
It has everything else.
Right.
So it's only just not riverfront. These guys, so instead of backing up, guys.
But I thought.
Hold
that
on a second.
That,
they're willing to look at that.
Yeah, but I thought that it would when you make the case that something is going to affect the wetlands, it has to be after the fact. I thought that was how it played out with that.
More likely than not. You know, it has to be not if and until.
I thought it was.
No, you deny it based on the fact that they didn't overcome the presumptions. And the presumptions that work in the buffer zone is, you know, they have to prove that they're not, you know, causing harm to the wetland. But then it's your burden, it's the commission's burden to say exactly what. These guys will only read this. They're not going to look through the Wetlands Protection Act to find out what you're talking about. You can't give them like the 30,000 foot view of your problem with this site. You have to have it all in front of them. So that's why I said you need to identify something like shading and tell them that it's warming the brook, and this is, and then you could say runoff also, and you could say habitat because it's all paved now. So those things. I mean, we're just talking here.
That they could appeal that, and I think that DEP would side with them. That's what I think.
Yeah, but
if they're willing to go through the process, and it sounds like they're working with the town just in general. I mean, it there's no harm in asking, and if, again, if they appeal, it's their choice to appeal.
No, I don't know. So DEP doesn't just appeal, and it's like, go ahead and do it, whatever you wanted to do. Sometimes they appeal and put conditions on it. So they could put a condition that says, yeah, do the project, but you know, we want you 28 feet away.
It could be a more torturous process to go through that than to just work within the extra 10 feet. But that's up to them.
Yeah. I don't know.
And that's why we were talking about parking, because believe it or not, they were like, so first off, this, we can back this whole thing up. So the town, and so I'm not the expert in this, but apparently that you need, the town requires, or maybe affordable housing requires 1.5 parking spots. They are providing 1.7. So obviously there's some buffer there. And there's like 6 or 10 spots in the front of this building. And how big is the parking spot? Is that 15 feet? Right? I need it to move. 15 feet would be fine. Eliminate those parking spots, because obviously the math says it's not needed, and move the place forward. It's simple. It's done. So
what was their reasoning for the 1.7 as opposed to the 1.5?
Oh, well, it's a marketing thing. He wants to have as many two-car parking spots as he possibly can. Makes sense. I would do the same thing. I would want two parking spots if I had a you know, two-bedroom apartment or something like that. But that doesn't mean there can't be parking somewhere else. So that's what the DRT meetings are about. What's going to come up, they don't wanna come to a meeting and get into, you know, back and forth. So they try to get it as good as possible.
Okay. Do I hear a motion to adjourn?
I make a motion to adjourn.
All those in favor? Meeting adjourned.